So let's discuss semaphores. Today's topic is semaphores. In last class, what we have discussed? We have discussed the hardware solution as we are looking for concurrency resolution. That if one process wants to take on the resources of CPU, it firstly has to acquire the lock, then do the activity, then release the lock. In this manner, there will be no interrupt by other processes. Okay, so in continuation, we are having the semaphore's value. What is a semaphore? A semaphore that you can denote with the value with the S is a non-negative integer variable that, apart from initialization, is accessed only through standard atomic operations. What are the two atomic standard operations? First one is wait, and second one is signal. First one is wait operation, and second one is signal operation. We will discuss what is there in the wait function and what is there in the signal operation. Okay. So what is a semaphore? Semaphore is a non-negative integer variable. We will implement that signaling system with the help of a non-negative integer variable. How we can give a signal with an integer variable, we will see. With the help of these two standard atomic operations, that is wait and signal. So firstly discuss wait operation. What is the wait operation? It was originally termed as P. We denoted wait as P. When we try to write the code, then from where P is derived from the Dutch word proberen, which what is the meaning of proberen is to test. Meaning of proberen is to test. It is derived from the Dutch word. Okay, and what is the meaning of that proberen is to test. Let's see the function. Here you can see we are having this wait function, and in wait function what we are doing, forget about this while, just saying that s minus minus, we are just decrementing the semaphore value. And when we are not able to decrement this semaphore value, whenever the value is less than or equal to zero, then what will happen? The process which is trying to acquire the lock on that semaphore will trap into this infinite loop. Understand? Suppose S value is 1 initially, then you will check while S is less than equal to 0, 1 is less than equal to 0, condition is false. So you will decrement the value of S. Okay, S minus minus. Suppose right now semaphore value is 0 and another process try to acquire the lock on that semaphore, then second process, suppose P2 comes and it picks the value of S, which is 0 right now, and it will check 0 is less than or equal to 0, condition is true, so it will trap into this infinite loop. It will keep continuing checking the S value. Is that process will not able to decrement the value of S. Okay, so do you understand this? Pretty simple code. Yes or no? How this wait function is working? Wait function is just for to decrement the value of S. S is an integer variable. Integer variable which is non-negative in nature. So if you are trying to decrement value, if it is less than equal to zero, then it will be trapped into this infinite loop. So this is the working of wait function, and S is an non-negative integer value. Okay. So let's see what is a signal function. A signal function was originally called V. We call whenever we try to write the code of signal, we will denote it as V. So from where this V is taken, this is from Dutch word verhogen. What is the meaning of verhogen? The meaning is to increment. So as the name suggests you, to test, wait function is for to test. We are checking if it is S value is less than equal to zero or not. If it is so, then you are trapped into an infinite loop. Else you can decrement the value of S. Similarly, whenever you are done with the execution of your process, you have to give the signal. You have to give the signal to other process that you have released the lock. And how you will give the signal? With the help of this signal operation. Very simple code. In signal, we have to simply increment the value of semaphore, right? So these are the two standard function, and they are doing only just one thing. Wait is for to decrement and signal is for to increment. Just remember the crux. Wait is to decrement, signal is to increment. Okay, just remember this. Wait function is to decrement the value of semaphore if it is not less than equal to zero, and signal function is to simply increment the value of semaphore. So let's see what are the different types of semaphore. There are two common type of semaphore. First one is counting semaphore. What is counting semaphore? Integer value can range over an unrestricted domain. Here in counting semaphore, we can use a range of values in an unrestricted domain. It is used for number of processes. It may be used to implement the solution of critical section problem with multiple processes. Where we are having more than two processes, then we can use the counting semaphore. And another variation is binary semaphore. As the name suggests, it is binary, means it can have only two values, either zero or one. So it is preferable for two processes which are running concurrently. So integer value can range only between zero and one. It can be simpler to implement, also known as mutex lock. Mutex means what? Mutual exclusion. Okay. Mutual exclusion means if one process is executing in its critical section, no other process will allow to enter its critical section. So in this manner, with the help of binary semaphore, we can take care of two processes. It may be used to control access to resource that has multiple instances. Okay, so in this manner, we can implement these two semaphore, counting semaphore and binary semaphore. Now, what is the concept of busy waiting? Can anyone give an example? I have already explained what is busy waiting in previous classes. Can anyone give an example of busy waiting? I have used this term so many times in previous classes, busy waiting. Can anyone tell me what is busy waiting? Come on, unmute yourself. Just recall previous classes, what I have explained. I have used this term so many times, busy waiting. Okay, I am giving you a short domain where you can search the answer. In Peterson's solution, we have used this term frequently, busy waiting. Do you remember now? Come on, unmute yourself. Anyone? Come on. In Peterson's solution, do you remember? Abhishek has an answer. The infinite while loop of Peterson solution. Very good, Shreyas. Abhishek is saying process checks repeatedly if condition is true. Very good, Abhishek. Yes, sir, in an infinite while loop. Very good. So what was doing in that infinite while loop? The process which is consuming the resources of CPU. How it is consuming the resources of CPU? Because it is frequently, or I can say continuously, checking the condition that flag is true or not. In the context of that Peterson solution, I'm explaining that flag is true or not and whose turn is this, right? It is continuously checking, right? And while you are checking some condition, you are consuming the resources of CPU, right? But you are not doing any fruitful thing. You are not progressing. You are not moving towards your goal. You are just stuck on one point and you are checking the condition again and again. Whose flag true or false, and condition whose turn it is. You are just keep checking. And till by time you are keep checking until and unless another process exited from its critical section. So in this manner, process is busy. He is busy. He is doing things. He is checking the conditions. But what is? He is waiting. The process is waiting. As I'm giving you an example, that suppose you have gone to a doctor, some dentist, right? But as one patient is already there, doctor is seeing that patient, and now you are in a hurry. You are just keep checking with the compounder. Is doctor free? Right? You are just keep checking. Is doctor free? You are waiting, right? You are waiting there. Your turn is still not. But you are busy in doing, checking that doctor is free or not. So this is what busy waiting. And what you are doing, you are consuming the resources. How you are consuming the resources? You are occupying the compounder. And by asking, is doctor is free, and now computer, that compounder has to give you answer. If you are not keep asking again and again in meal time, in that time computer can do anything else, right? So it is good if, like, you are sitting on a waiting queue in a chair, and computer can give you a signal whenever your turn comes, right? So in this manner you can sit there, you cannot consume the resources of your compounder. Whenever your turn comes, compounder will give you a signal. Suppose it is a token system, with the help of token you can give an alert to the waiting process that okay, it's your turn, right? Have you seen, whenever you have gone in a bank like SBI or other things, there is a token system, you generate a slip and on the like board that token number are running and which counter you have to go, right? Now, these are the things that you are not like some kind of busy waiting kind of thing. You can sit there and look for your turn. So what is a busy waiting? Let's see. The repeated execution of a loop of code while waiting for an event to occur is called busy waiting, right? You are just looking for a condition again and again, but you are waiting for an event to occur. The repeated execution of a loop of codes, this is what busy waiting. CPU is in this, when you are in a busy waiting, CPU is not engaged in any real productive activity during this period, and the process does not progress towards completion. So this is just a waste of resources. You are not progressing, you are not doing any productive activity, you are just engaging the CPU to checking the condition again and again. So when a process executes the wait operation and finds that the semaphore value is not positive, it must wait. Now think that if you are looking for a doctor's appointment, but the doctor is busy with the patient, then what you can do? You can wait. And where you can wait? You can wait in some waiting queue. However, rather than engaging in busy waiting, the process can block itself. Now the patient can be blocked. How it can be blocked? It can be requested to sit, please sit on the chair. Your turn, when your turn will come, I will give you a signal. The block operation places a process into a waiting queue associated with the semaphore, and the state of the process is switched to the waiting state. Then control is transferred to the CPU scheduler, which selects another process to execute. A process that is blocked waiting on a semaphore S should be restarted when some other process executes a signal operation. Right? You are sitting on a chair waiting for a signal given by whom? Like compounder, that doctor is free, right? So whenever that signal will come, the process will be restarted to when the process execute a signal operation. Whenever another process given a signal operation, then you will be restarted to go and check the doctor. The process is restarted by a wake up operation, which changes the process from waiting state to the ready state. Now when you are waiting into the waiting queue, and when you get the wake up operation, how you get the wake up operation will do a signal that okay, your turn is there, keep ready. Now you will be sent to the ready state. The process is then placed into the ready queue. To implement semaphores, under the definition, we define a semaphore as follows. Let's see. Do you remember structures you have studied in your last year? This is when you have studied your linked list. This is the same as your singly linked list. Do you remember singly linked list? When you make a structure of a singly linked list, do you remember singly linked list? Yes or no? Do you remember singly linked list data structure? Okay, yeah. So you can see this is the same as your singly linked list. Here you can have a node which is having two values. First one is your value, and second one is the address of another node, right? So this is the same as your singly linked list. So in this structure, you can see here, with the help of value, you can put the semaphore value, and there is a address to the another semaphore. So this is pretty simple definition of a semaphore. Let's move. how to implement this semaphore implementation with no busy waiting. Now we are going to implement the semaphore with no busy waiting thing. As you know, that busy waiting is just consuming the resources of CPU. So we are trying to avoid that situation, which is the issue with the software solution of Peterson. Right. So let's see how we can avoid this busy waiting kind of thing, which is occurring while you are waiting for your turn. So firstly, let's see wait function. Now, as you are aware, that wait function is just for to decrement the value of semaphore. So if you are talking about that structure, then how to access that value? You have to put the S, then this member of operator, then S dot value minus minus. You are simply decreasing the value with the help of this wait function, and you check that if that value is less than zero, then you have to make that process wait into the queue and block it. If this is not less than zero, you just simply acquire the log. Think that suppose you go first and doctor is free. Now you have acquired the semaphore of doctor, which is initially one, that doctor is free. You take the semaphore value with minus minus, means you acquire the lock on the doctor, right? And you check that S dot value is less than zero, means one here you are putting that initially value of the semaphore is one. Now you are decrementing. Now what is the value? It is zero. Now you will check zero is less than zero. Condition is false. You will not trap into this block. You are good to go with the critical section. But suppose second patient came at the same time, it tried to acquire the lock on that semaphore of doctor. Now it again get the value of S, which is right now what? Zero. Now it decrement the value of zero. Then what is? It is minus one. Now minus one is less than zero. Condition is true. So second process will be trapped into this waiting queue. Do you get this function? Pretty simple. Yes or no? Do you get this function? Okay. Cool. So let's see how wait function work. This wait function is done. Now we look at the signal function. Signal function is just to increment the value. Okay, Krishnam is saying one more time. So if I explain this in the same manner, you will not get understand. Let me have my PowerPoint here. Let's see. Okay. So what we are talking about, we need a semaphore value. Let's have a semaphore value. Okay. And what is the name it? And this is semaphore. Okay. Doctor semaphore, semaphore doc. Okay, and this is the semaphore of doctor, and initial value of semaphore is one, right? See, if you are having your pen and paper, you will never have an issue. Whenever I'm explaining you anything, just take your pen and paper and just visualize those things what I am explaining. Now if I have explained you right in this manner, you are not able to get. So now what I am doing, I am taking my pen and paper and explaining on the physical manner. So if you are trying to understand these things, you can also do the same thing. Now do you understand? This is how wait function is going to do. This is semaphore. Now let's see, we are having two processes here, a process P1, and here we are having a process P2, right? There are two processes. Now what will happen? P1 comes into the picture. Let me make it my forget. Okay, now what will happen? P1 comes into the picture. Okay, it will check. It will try to firstly acquire the lock. It will try to acquire the lock firstly. So let's acquire the lock. So P1 executed this wait S function. Now, what will this wait function will do? You will go to this wait function. Now check S dot value minus one S. What is the value here? You can see here, this is value, a semaphore value, right? This is doctor semaphore value is right now one. Now what you have done, S dot value minus minus. So what is the updated value of S right now? What is the updated value of S right now? Tell me.
Zero, sir.
Very good. So make it zero. Remove this one. Make it zero. Make it zero. So far, so good. Cool. So far, so good. No, no issue. We are still executing P1. So now check this one. Check this condition. Tell me this condition is true or false. Is this condition true or false? Come on.
False.
False. Of course, this is false. S dot value is what? Zero. Zero is not less than zero. Condition is false. So you will not trap into this. P1 will not trap into this, right? Yes. P1 will not trap into this. So this will function executed successfully. Now let's see. You are executing in your critical section. Here you are. You have started executing your critical section. Now you have entered into your critical section and you are good to go. Miss, doctor is, you are seeing the doctor right now. Now what happened? Still you are with the doctor. P2 comes into the picture. Now P2 says, I also want to see the doctor. So compounder said, okay, check the weight function. If you can acquire the log, you can go to meet the doctor. Now again, that weight function is required by this P2. Now what will happen? Tell me, what will happen if P2 required the acquire the lock on this semaphore of doctor and that doctor is busy with P1? Now tell me, what will happen? What will happen? Just go execute the same function. Now S dot value minus minus. What will be the updated value of the semaphore? Come on. Updated value is minus one, right? So it is minus one. Let's make it minus one. It's minus one. Now check this condition. Is this condition true or false? Is this condition true or false?
True, sir.
True. Nah? So you will enter into this condition. So what will happen with this P2? Add this process to waiting queue. Now you will be there into the waiting queue, right? And you will be blocked. And you will be blocked. Means once P1 is there in its critical section, P2 will not be allowed to acquire the log. As you can see, until and unless this wait function is completed, you cannot acquire the log, right? P1 has successfully executed this wait function. So it is done with its critical section. Means wait function is done. Now P2 is still executing in wait function and how it has been blocked into the waiting queue. Until and unless a signal operation is given, you cannot be removed from the waiting queue. So are we good with this? Cool?
Yes, everyone? Sir.
So
yes,
let's sir. Move on. So this is the wait function. Now let's check for the signal function. Let me explain this also. Okay. I have to make it like it. See how this will happen. This is the signal operation. Now, if P1 is done with this critical section, P2, then what it will do? Once critical section is done, it will exit section is there and then it will give you a signal. Let me make it copy. Then P1 will execute this operation, right? It will give the signal. And how it will give the signal? Let's see. S dot value plus plus. Now, what is the updated value? It is zero. Updated value will be zero. Uh-oh. Firstly, remove this. Make it. So updated value is zero. So check if S dot value less than equal to zero, then remove a process from the waiting queue. Now with a process which is waiting into the waiting queue and give the signal with the help of this wake up operation. Now P2 was, which was there into the waiting queue, it will be given a wake up call. And once a wake up call is there, it will increment, it will give the signal to this P2. Now P2 can execute. Okay. Do you understand? Signal operations?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Let's move on. So we are done with this pretty simple code, weight function and signal function. So, but as you can see here that we are seeing that, okay, we are done with this. It is pretty simple solution. We can, in this manner, we can solve the problem of concurrency, but you know, nothing is perfect. There are some drawbacks. So what are the drawbacks with this semaphore? We can have a situation of a deadlock. What is the situation of a deadlock? Can anyone give a real world example? This solution of semaphore suffers with the deadlock situation. Can anyone tell me what is a deadlock situation? Come on. Pretty simple. Any real world scenario of deadlock? Come on. Come on. Think of it. Any deadlock situation? You are not able to think. Come on, anyone? Deadlock situation, any scenario, real world scenario of deadlock. I am waiting. I am waiting. Are you trapping me into an infinite loop? And I am busy. I am doing the busy waiting thing means I am keep asking. I am busy in asking and still I am waiting, right? See, this is an example of busy waiting right now. Come on, anyone? Deadlock? See, you can draw the meaning from the deadlock. A dead means, dead end means you are gonna finished, and lock is you are bound somewhere. Abhishek is saying tie. No, this is not just similar as tie. This is something else. In tie, what will happen? Both the processes, both the party are agree with this. Suppose there is a tie in a cricket match, then both the party are agree with this. But in deadlock, this is not the case. They are angry with each other that you are blocking my resources. Come on, tell. Who will explain? Deadlock barrier. Come with an example. Don't give some random words. There is no way to go out. Yeah, give me an example. Na? Give me a real world situation. Give me a real world situation. Are you not able to think a deadlock situation? It is everywhere. Where you are sharing the resources, this deadlock situation is everywhere. Think about your life where you are sharing your resource. Come on. Oh my God. I am waiting. I need 2 to 3 answers. Shall I take the name of a student only? Then you will speak about the deadlock. A remote problem in TV case. So please explain. Just you can not give away with this remote problem in TV case. You have to explain. Traffic can only be in one direction. So how it is a deadlock situation? If traffic can be only in one direction, this is so good. If traffic can be go in one direction only, we are having two way, one direction and then there is another way. Explain your answer. Explain your answer. Priyam, please explain your answer. Priyam, please explain your answer. Come on, time is less. You are taking too much of time. If I got locked in a room and lost in, no, this is not the case. This is not the case. I am telling you that any situation we are sharing the resources with other persons, only where you can see the situation of a deadlock. Oh my God. Priyam, how can you explain your remote problem in TV? Come on.
Sir, in the case of TV, if two programs are running at the same time, and if me and my mother or anybody wants to see that program, then it will be a deadlock situation between me and my mother that right. We both wants to
take the remote in their hand because they want to see their interested activity into the TV, right? But
Yes.
They are saying, they are asking you to please release the remote, and you are asking to release the remote. Suppose your mother is taking the remote, and what you are having in your hand, the power button of your TV. You are asking, give me a remote, yes, otherwise sir. I will switch off the TV, and mother is asking, remove means away from your TV. I have a remote, I will watch. So everyone is asking for something to other resources which is acquired by them. And Abhishek is saying, if two patient needs to see the doctor, okay. It may be the case, but you have to explain, just like we have discussed that TV issue. A thing about a road. Let me have a PowerPoint again. Think about suppose this is a road I am making. I am making this road. Let me make it proper road. Okay, so what will happen? Suppose here is a large truck coming in this direction, right? And suppose there is another large truck coming in this direction, and this is only one road, no two-way road. Now this driver A is saying to driver B, please go back, so that think about, this is just like a flyover kind of thing, or we can have something else. Means there is only one road and two trucks are facing each other. Now A is asking B, please backtrack, please go back so that I can go first, and B is asking A, you can go back and so that I can move forward. So this is a deadlock situation. And these are the pretty simple situation you can see in everywhere in your life, wherever you are sharing the resources. What is the sharing resource between A and B right now? What is the sharing resource between A and B? A and B is sharing which resource right now? Tell me. What is the resource shared by A and B right now? The road. Very good. Very good. The road is the shared resource. Cool. So this is a deadlock situation. So let's see. Two or more processes are waiting indefinitely for an event that can be caused by one of the waiting processes. Means either you release the remote or another person release that power button of the TV. Only then the process can progress. Consider a system consisting of two processes, P0 and P1, each accessing two semaphores, S and Q, set to the value 1. Let's have an example. What we are having? We are having a P0 process and P1 process. P0 has executed, wait on S means acquire the lock on S, and then P1 has acquired the lock on Q. Now P0 is trying to acquire the lock on Q, but he cannot, because firstly, P1 has acquired the lock on Q, right? Let me explain in next slide. This is the situation. Now, let's see. Suppose P0 execute wait S, that is, now P0 has acquired the lock on S, and then P1 execute wait Q. Now, P1 has acquired the lock on Q. Now, next, P0 try to execute wait Q operation, but how it can properly execute this wait operation? It must wait until P1 executes signal Q, but signal Q is not given by P1. It is still executing in its critical section, right? Similarly, when P1 execute wait S, it must wait until P0 execute until it executes signal operation on S. So these signals operation cannot be executed. P0 and P1 are in deadlock situation. See, P0 has acquired the lock on S, but has not given the signal. Now P1 is trying to execute the wait S function, but it will be trapped because signal is not given by the P0 on S, right? So do you understand this deadlock situation? Pretty simple. You cannot acquire a lock until and unless it is released by the process which has the lock. Are we good with this deadlock example? Yes or no? Cool. So this is the deadlock situation that can occur in this semaphore solution of the critical section problem. And there is another issue. This is starvation. What is starvation? This is indefinite blocking. How you will trap into this situation of starvation? Suppose you have gone to the doctor to see him at 10 a.m. and what is the timing of a clinic from 10 a.m. to like 2 p.m. Right after that, the doctor will leave. You gone there at 10 a.m. but still doctor is busy with the patient, so you are requested to please wait, and once your turn will come, we will wake you up. Now you are waiting, and patient is not leaving the doctor's room. So at that time 2 p.m. will happen and doctor is leaving. So you are just keep waiting, looking for the resource, but resource is not given to you, and you starve in this manner. So a process may never be removed from the semaphore queue in which it is suspended. So this is the issue with this semaphore solution also. We have to take care of this deadlock and starvation solution, starvation issues. So we are done with today's class. We have discussed today semaphore